What's up to all my dearest friends? And hello to the global digital highway. Here we are putting all our gut and soul out there for the internet. Welcome to the Coastal Poets Film Festival. For those who don't know me, I'm Corbin Lewis, a Seattle poet invested in punk, disability, and multimedia. The upcoming five poems are genuine, tender, and ruthlessly passionate. In the following order, this film festival presents Allison Morton, Simon Wolf, Brent Cox, Shelby Handler, and myself. These are artists who have all invested a lifetime into poetic craft and raising a creative consciousness. I can't speak for all these poets' intentions and goals, but here's why I'm curating this festival. Because I believe it's the poet's responsibility to make work that demands self-knowledge and social change. What I see in these videos is the power of DIY art to stimulate more community care and intention. Poetry can stretch the skull, open perception, and reteach our violent history in favor of honesty and critical thinking. There is no definitive reason why poems matter, but I believe these ones represent decades of scholarship and community organizing. Everyone in this film festival does fucking work. Without funding or profit in mind, just curiosity and hunger. They are career teachers, scholars, and weirdos, joined together in offering the labor of academic thought and creative love. So thank you to all the artists who are part of this beating joyful effort. A thank you to the viewership, which translates to community support. I could not be more proud and fucking stoked to present these five poems. So please enjoy and peace out. Thank you.
decadence. There is no silence. The sound of wind and breath remain. At night, I do not sleep. I dream. Each morning, I have to remember where I left off. Along the edge of city meeting woods, there is always garbage. Objects built for one use last longer than their users. Only when time is limited can anything appear solid. As in, time kills everything, meaning what does a lifetime witness? In a clear, wordless field, I have forgotten everything. At the shore, the tide exists without me, outside language, inside my senses. Every day happens in general, a particular repetition along the line necessarily ends. We planted a maple for Pa, buried his favorite candy with the roots. We each have somewhere above 280 grams of heart. It is rarely the big thing that can be relied on. River looks the same from the bank slowly eroding. The current is never the same. Different water fills similar space. The cedar stump will outlast me near where the old timers called the sweet water. In love, there is trust that the roots will bend but not break when the storm comes to take what isn't heavy enough to hold. Beach glass shows time like no other for what it is. A de-uniformed shape that blurs when put to the eye. The river's straightened curves reflect industrial all year round. Water past town, infinite bramble. Murky with chemicals and runoff, the tide goes out past the green. Plastic chair pilings taking years to fall. Barbed wire around the factory empty on Sunday. Fishers cast their net and jeer at the broken bridge above. Because the name means people of the inside, the river was sewn in, kept tangibly static. Gulls pile into the sky over the tugboat that doesn't stop to hear the story of hardhack and salmon, of how burning down longhouses was called improvement. The river, sky's color, on a winter day the sun momentarily bursts from clouds. The full moon lays in the water midway, or the water is more sky than land. And what could shine? The desert sand brown of the reed, the dust green of the sedge. The Madrone is royal. For the river, there is repetition only and the color of one more day. At Lucille, there was a line of RVs along the curb, biding their time before the next sweep. No one is outside of them. Their doors are closed. Two with propane tanks out front, one hanging from the doorknob, each with a unique pile, rugs, tarps, clothes, random parts of electronics. Bikes all missing one part of themselves leaning up against the back. Hanging from one's rearview mirror is a mobile made of off-cuttings of wood. Another has, out from the roof, a Halloween collection of skulls. A block north, a man and a woman start a fire in front of their van. The smoke combines with the factories. A block south, four paper birches stand out along a thin rectangle of faded grass. Their bark is a layer that must be peeled back to grow. Between Blanchard and Bell, a frail man smokes a hand-rolled cigarette, fraying at the end. His beard is brown near his chin, then gray and long to his right knee, crossed, then tucked under his left. His right elbow on the inside of his folded right thigh, his body wrenched north at the waist. On his right hand, the pointer, middle, and thumb are a deep orange brown. Blocks away, a cherry tree blossoms in between Buckley's and the parking garage. Here, the sun only comes in sharp pieces. Slices and shapes only buildings can make fall onto the sidewalk, paved overcast before getting dimmer and disappearing. Buildings grow bigger towards downtown on this street that has been here far longer than me, but is still not the only thing.
This is a work from the perspective of time. It is composed of 5-second corpuscles. Each corpuscle is nested among 12 neighboring corpuscles into a unit of 60 seconds, a minute. Each minute, that is, each set of 12 5-second corpuscles represents a year of time. This means each corpuscle corresponds to something like a month of time. Every corpuscle is an excerpt from or represents one significant project composed during its nested year. There are 6 sets of 12 5-second corpuscles, so the project represents 6 years of time in a life. The duration subjected to representation here is from the beginning of January 2015 to the end of December 2020. This makes for 72 total corpuscles, which happens to be the number of languages spoken at the Tower of Babel, the number of the names of God according to the Kabbalah, the number of disciples said to have mastered Confucius philosophy, the number of disciples sent forth to spread the word of Jesus, the original number of books in the book of Revelation, the number of degrees of Jacob's ladder according to the Zohar, the number of houri promised to Muslim martyrs, the number of major temples at Angkor Wat, as well as the number of sects of Islam doomed to hell according to Muhammad's hadith. The Egyptian god Thoth wins 1/72nd of each day of the year from the moon in a game of something like checkers, and uses these extra days to give birth to gods and goddesses. This also means there are 6 sets of 60 seconds, adding to a total of 360 seconds, the number of degrees in a circle. Each corpuscle of time is of this circle, every second something like a degree. And there is only one. There is only one circle.
Metal on metal.
Like something had been missing before, and now I have it.
Murder is murder. Freedom is freedom. Murder is murder. Murder is murder.
As you descend through a hurtling abyss of time, some have called it a sick.
Science has failed. Time kills. Use life. Dear Chris Burden,
it's because I'm a monodualist.
What? Oh, is this
there? Maybe birds at the end of the pier. You know, the way we think, and once you get there, they might fly away.
The only thing that catches me up is doing my magic act.
Does it make you afraid? Does it make you afraid?
I am fire!
Hey, loneliness, become nothing. No. Thank you all for coming tonight. Thank you to Ted and Rebecca, given the recent political catastrophe.
Moment of extreme violence.
I say this right. How do we know that this is the order of the alphabet, presumably? Memorization, ideology, etc.
Dear Z, hoax drowned, inclined toward oblique nixed love from sky, interrogation via shadow.
Waitman's photographs of Michael Heiser's double.
Dear Quartz Land, whoever knew that not ready to violate new is that purity cavern of gems yearning.
An ocean that love finds no has concealed, not to hide but for discovery. The poetry world, of course, is a quantum entanglement. Please welcome Ray Armantrout.
Just preceding this quote, Howe writes that abstraction of the particular.
I really just wanted to make a movie about one of my plants. See, it doesn't belong here in Western New York.
Honesty.
One of the formal problems of tall buildings is that they produce suicide. Welcome, Jill Maggie.
But the epistemological claims of any and all discipline in the undetermined reading, the determinant.
It is my poetics document to document the crystallization.
I'd like to suggest
here in a field
that has something to do with Charles W. Mills' conception of white epistemological ignorance.
The following is a reading. My name is Legion, and in every nation I multi.
Being about language. In The American Grain, William Carlos.
Oh Lord, what have we done?
I enjoy in a narrative. The avant-garde is never anything but
the dashes suture the eye.
Alice wrote a new poem.
The topological view critiques critical distance as a metaphorical colonialism that depends on fiction.
The money form effaces the material of murder and the murderous organization of the present.
I suggest that the power of poetry, and especially recent poetry, self-consciously takes the video of language itself in order to demonstrate.
This is Niagara Falls. The Niagara River was for many fugitive slaves
without identity. Their voices that explicitly include me in them.
Our own noisiness emerges from the late capitalist mandate to compulsory work and
time she went down.
Any gift does, this is its poison. There's a counter narrative.
The question is, Pritchard's work has been freely available on Eclipse for 25 years.
And the glow of the evening sun.
Brian's work is especially attentive to the granular elements of language, indeed, as he argues in The Excellent Word Toys.
Let's get our terms straight. An apple is the ripened ovary of the tree's blossom. And you are that of my eye. blush-cheeked proof that sweetness is a solid strategy for survival, as long as one also spits their bitter seeds into the face of the future. This is what I have for you. I lost a ring in the garden. A carrot grew straight through it. You don't want a wedding? How about a weeding? I pulled all the thistles from the purse lane, laid them at the altar of your doughy toes. Love stinks up the entire yard with its compost heap, and thank God for that aliveness. Only the worms really know what's going on in a relationship. Love takes my breath away and gives it to the apple trees, and they give it back to me and to you, to all of us who hopelessly yearn towards the moon, that useless sky seed that makes no plant grow except the poet. What's the point? The first time I laid eyes on you, I did so slowly, each eyeball like a cool washcloth on a fevered forehead. I offered you a pluot, so ripe it had to be eaten, and you chose to eat it because you wanted to, not because it would rot otherwise.
Tribute to the aughts, with its chat rooms and Oxycontin. Back when my peers looked like skate rats. Tribute to new trucks, both skateboards and whips. We circled North Seattle the way cops do, searching out drugs that were easy to find. And what a way to hurt yourself. Now my friends say no regrets, only tributes. So tribute the heroin lovers, their lulls which hang like oblivion in dirt cake bedrooms. Tribute to band posters from 03. We attended the dopamine concert. We strolled through the halls of laissez-faire and wrote epitaphs in graffiti. Here lies the lava lamp thrown out by mom 2006. Here lies the modem which powered our escape. Here lies the sticky note that held the product key and address to Hannah's. Here lies the big gulp. Here lies the billabong. Here lies the dog bones. We pray to so many cardboard boxes. We drink moonshine resurrection, but mostly we smoke and try to outrun ourselves, with each moment carrying forward like delayed pixels stuck on a screen, our lives overlapping in distorted light. The goal is to move on, regardless of timing. A tribute to running late. Tribute to Bic lighters exploding on the driveway. Hot flash of bodies. Tribute to a slim chance of getting laid. And especially tribute to getting laid. There was not enough time to mention who did what, at least not in full detail. And there was not enough storage in our heads for a proper tribute, one that honors the third highest branch of the 17-year-old spruce tree from Paramount Skate Park, where we smoked and caught our breath with open scabs, cooling beneath the shade. So much homage is due to that tree, which we climbed to see the asteroids fall in winter's mouth on the day before homecoming, when Mariah bailed on James last minute and he showed up to the dance drunk in a t-shirt from Zoomies with four marijuana plants printed on the back. Tribute to that shit. Tribute to MIPs. tribute to the last kegger of 2009, which varies depending on who you are. Much like dosage and tolerance of vodka and MDA and sunlight, most of us can only take so much before the gravity sweeps us into tremors. I have shivered through the morning. I have blacked out from headaches, and I have drugged my way through the 2000s. And none of this is unique, especially to us, who spent years jumping ship from pill to tar or girlfriend to bottle. We ran our bodies into the ground, or at least the hospital, at least the crash site. So tribute to debris. The smell of hot metal. Tribute to the forge. Even if we turned out crooked. Tribute to getting up. I know it hurts. We all do. But regardless, tribute.